Hello, my dear students. We are solving exercise 1.5 of NCERT. In this exercise, we have to identify, in very first question, we have to identify what numbers are rationals and what are irrationals. So, as I told you, if you would have seen my last video in which I have discussed about rationalization, if you have not seen that video, so I request you to watch that video at least once. So this kind of number, rational plus irrational or rational minus irrational, is an irrational number. What kind of this number is? An irrational number. In this case, root 23 would be cancelled, and therefore this result is 3, which is 3 upon 1, and this number is what? This number is rational, because all natural integers are rational numbers. And similarly here, root 7 would be cancelled, and 2 by 7 is a rational number. And about this, 1 by root 2, this is rational and this is irrational. So outcome is irrational. What is that? Irrational. Even if I remove this root 2 with the help of multiplying and dividing by root 2, 1 by root 2, after rationalizing it, its denominator will be root 2 into root 2 is 2, and numerator is root 2, even though it is an irrational number. And 2 pi, as you know that pi is what? Pi is an irrational number, so multiplying it with 2, 4, 5, 7 and whatsoever it is, it will remain an irrational number. So what kind of this number is irrational number? So this was about your question number 1. Let's discuss question number 2, in which we are supposed to simplify these expressions. So let's simplify. In this, we shall multiply this 3 with this bracket, 2 plus root 2, and root 3 with this, and let's see what is the outcome. 3 into 2 is 6, plus 3 root 2, plus root 3 into 2 is 2 root 3. Root 3 into root 2 is root 6. Why? Because root A into root B is root A into B. So this is 6 plus 3 root 2 plus 2 root 3, the same result. No need to write it again. But in this question, I think that here it should be root 3 as per the question. So a plus b into a minus b can be applied now. So what is that? A square minus b square. A plus b into a minus b is a square minus b square. So it is 3 square minus root 3 square. 9 minus 3. And 9 minus 3 is what? 9 minus 3 is 6. So its outcome is, its simplified value is 6. It cannot be simplified further, but its simplified value is 6. Here we can use a plus b whole square. What is a plus b whole square? A plus b whole square is a square plus b square plus 2ab. So it is root 5 square plus root 2 square plus 2 into root 5 into root 2. So what is this? Root 5 square is 5, root 2 square is 2, plus 2 into root 5 into root 2 will be root 10, 5 2 is 10. So 5 plus 2 is 7, 7 plus 2 root 10. This again we can use a minus b into a plus b, and what is that? A square minus b square. A minus b into a plus b is a square minus b square. Root 5 square minus root 2 square. Root 5 square is 5 minus root 2 square is 2. 5 minus 2 is what? 3. So its simplified value is 3. Let's discuss question number 3. In question number 3, it is asked that recall pi is defined as the ratio of circumference of a circle and its diameter. Circumference and diameter, and C be the circumference and D be the diameter, and we are told that it is the ratio of C by D, ratio of circumference and diameter. Of course it is true. What is circumference of a circle? You know, 2 pi r. And what is diameter? Double of radius. 2r get cancelled. And what is this? This is pi. So in the question, it is saying that this seems C by D is what? C by D is what? C by D is pi. C by D is what? You can see here, C by D is pi. This seems to contradict the fact that pi is irrational number. How will you resolve this contradiction? Means, mind it, it's a very important question, because I told you that a rational number will be in the form of p by q. And here, this pi is in the form of what? Pi is in the form of c by d. Pi is in the form of c by d. So should it be a rational? But we used to say that pi is an irrational number. So mind it, whenever you are asked to draw a point on a real line, you draw or you mark a point on real line, but this is not its exact location. It's approx location of the point. It is approx location, approximate location. It is not the exact location. That is why it seems that this is a fixed point, but it is not a fixed point, because when we locate this C on the number line, this point will not be at the exact location where it should be. And similarly, D cannot be marked at the exact location, because whenever we mark a point, there should be an ambiguity. So C and D, marking to these C and D online, writing is not a problem. But when we mark point C and point D on the real line, or drawing the circumference of this value and drawing a diameter of this, will not be exact as per it should be. That is why this is not a contradiction, and you should not keep much about this in your mind, that this is not an irrational number. It is an irrational number, and I told you in earlier video, I don't know which video is that, but pi is what? Sometimes we write pi as 22/7. So is it exact value of pi? No, it's not an exact value of pi. And I request you to search more about pi. Pi is non-terminating, non-repeating, but its outcome, 22/7, you will find after some steps, it will be starting repeating. Means it will be non-terminating but a repeating. And what is pi? Pi is non-terminating and non-repeating. But it will be what? Non-terminating but repeating. So keep this thing in mind, and there should be no contradiction in your mind. And what you can write, that these lengths, whenever we wish to scale them and when we draw them, they are not remain exact up to their values. and that is why it seems that pi is not an irrational number, but pi is a rational number. And in the next question, question number 4, you are asked to draw a square root of 9.3. So I request you to watch my exclusive video on drawing a square root of 3.5, 4.5, square root of 7.3, like this. So you will be able to draw this point on real line. In question number 5, we are asked to rationalize the denominator. So let's rationalize the denominator. First is 1 upon root 7. So we have to remove this irrational value by multiplying and dividing by root 7, so that the number remains an equivalent number and denominator becomes a rational value. Root 7 into root 7, 7. Similarly, its second question, 1 by root 7 minus root 6. Again, to rationalize it, use this kind of thing. If here we have minus, then use plus in between them. Numerator is root 7 plus root 6, and denominator will be root 7 square minus root 6 square. Root 7 plus root 6 upon root 7 square is 7, root 6 square is 6, 7 minus 6 is 1, and 1 in denominator is of no importance. You can write it simply root 7 plus root 6, because a upon 1 is what? a, but 1 upon a is not a. Keep this thing in mind. Third is 1 upon root 5 plus root 2. So to rationalize it, you will have to multiply both numerator and denominator by root 5 minus root 2. So the outcome will be root 5 minus root 2, and very easily you can find the value of this denominator, root 5 square minus root 2 square. Root 5 minus root 2, 5, root 5 square is 5 minus root 2 square is 2, 5 minus 2 is 3. So root 5 minus root 2 upon 3. And similarly, the question number 4, 1 upon root 7 minus 2, multiply and divide by root 7 plus 2. Root 7 plus 2, and in a denominator you can use that formula, a minus b a plus b, a square minus b square, root 7 square minus 2 square, root 7 plus 2, root 7 square is 7 minus 2 square is 4, root 7 plus 2 upon 3. So this is the simplified equivalent form after rationalizing the denominator. So hope you would have enjoyed this topic, enjoyed this exercise. My best wishes with you. Keep practicing. I am Dr. Rakesh Kumar Tripathi, your friend, your guide, advisor. Wish you all the best.